When we think about people who work at tech companies, we often think of software engineers coding day in and day out. But what if I told you that there were other well-paying tech jobs which didn't involve as much coding? On my recent trip to Microsoft's headquarters, I wanted to learn more about these other jobs at Microsoft. I sat down with three Microsoft employees.
Hi, I'm Taryn. I'm a design researcher working in DevDev research, so working with our developers that use Azure.
My name is Linzi. I'm a UX researcher working at Microsoft, like on the developer experiences on Azure.
My name is Dheeraj Bandaru. I am a product manager at Microsoft.
I've been here for about 3.5 years.
I am coming up on 2 years.
I joined Microsoft during the pandemic.
Working on services like Azure App Service, Azure Functions, Container Apps, Static Web Apps in the same product area, which is Azure PaaS.
PaaS stands for Platform as a Service. We'll talk more about this in a future video. Now on to Linzi.
We are running customer research and customer study to help the product team make better informed decisions. Specifically, we do customer interview, which we're trying to understand their mindset, their mental model, their point of view on lots of the behaviors. We also run some studies concept value test when the product team is still ideating on the concept, but not sure if that's what the customer values. We will just put it in front of the users or the participant again. Feedback on the limitations and benefits.
This is a Microsoft lab where user studies are held. Users sit behind this window and UX researchers on this end. Now on to Dheeraj.
I work as the PM for static web apps, as well as some strategic research and growth for the Azure PaaS team.
So I asked him, what does your work entail?
A couple days a week, I have meetings with stakeholders such as the engineering team, the research team, design, business planning, marketing, etc. And then we have a lot of other teams that work on other products that partner with us. So I meet with their PMs to figure out if everything is going according to plan, if we need to do anything different. And then a couple of days a week, I have interviews with customers and setting that up. So we have a couple of research studies going on to help us identify future steps in our roadmap for the product. And in order to help with that process, we talk to customers and figure out how they're using the product and how they want to be using the product going forward. And then part of my time is spent on building demos and content. So writing up docs with the doc team, as well as creating demos using the product. So building websites, deploying them in different ways.
As it turns out, it's not only product managers that work with other teams. UX or user experience researchers do as well.
We actually work very closely with both the product team and the engineering team. So we'll talk to them to understand what is their concerns, what's the question they're trying to learn from the users. And we also sit together. We also have a centralized UX research team group meeting that we will share best practices, get feedback from others. I actually really like being able to collaborate with cross-functionals or with cross teams, because that really helps you to open your eyes. We're giving you a different point of view and helping you understand the problems and also other solutions from a different kind of perspective. And the challenge of being that was that you have to always make sure over communicate to either about your ideas, your thinking, or your reasoning, and also get feedback, just to make sure everyone is on the same page and aligned with your action plan moving forward. And I think that was the challenging part. You have to make sure everyone was on board. And if you're working with teams that are kind of from different parts of the world, the time zone difference could be some challenge. And also you have to coordinating the feedback, and you have to make sure documenting the progress really well. So at least anyone that's involved in the project have some document to refer to if they're not part of the meeting.
I was pretty nervous when I first started this role a couple years ago that I would never really enjoy my job because I'm not a developer and I'm supposed to be working with a developer. And as a researcher, I think one of my biggest jobs or my key job is to be able to empathize with our customers. And to me, it felt impossible to empathize with a customer that I don't really understand, not being a developer myself. But along the way, I've learned a lot. I feel like I can now, I'm still not a developer, but I understand more about our products, how they work, why people need them, how they use them. So it's really interesting. And I also think just being in the center of like the technological ecosystem is cool, right? Because right now with the development of all these AI tools, with cloud becoming so much more popular and Microsoft being a key player and all of that, to be part of that ecosystem is really exciting as a researcher.
It sounded to me like PMs and UX researchers needed soft skills and technical know-how for their role. So I wondered, what do you do in college to become a PM and UX researcher?
I went to Georgia Tech for my undergrad. I majored in computer science and had a business certificate in sustainable business. And I'm currently a part-time student at the University of Chicago, getting my master's in computer science. I think the main things that I did in college to prepare myself for this role was I pursued a lot of personal projects and student organizations. I had my own nonprofit in college, which gave me a lot of experience growing a product, even if it was a clothing brand, as opposed to something maybe more technical. I had a decent amount of technical personal projects that also required me to grow them a lot, from building it engineering wise, as well as like partnering with people that had different data that I needed, etc. And then in terms of on campus, there's a student organization that I had to build and grow. Again, just being able to grow things that even if they were non-technical, the act of growing an organization or a product or a company gave me a lot of experience with what I do here every day.
I think my getting here to Microsoft is a pretty long process. Maybe I took a road very windy, but I've always had the goal of becoming a researcher, especially a human researcher, from a long time ago. So I went to Carnegie Mellon as my undergrad, and there I did a major in cognitive science. So understanding people's mental models, how our neurons fire, psychology behind how we make decisions, which is very much related to being a UX researcher. I also at that point did a minor in human-computer interaction, which is very much relevant to how people use our Azure services. From there, I decided that I wanted to develop my research portfolio. So I did a PhD at the University of Washington in human-centered design and engineering, focusing on how people collaborate on an online community. So things like Wikipedia, especially when they might be using different languages. And like both of those experiences as an undergrad and as a PhD student, like I was developing my research portfolio. I learned as a PhD student how to conduct research from start to end, even though it did take a really long time. Also developing methodology, like the skills for various methodologies. To me, that's like the most important thing that you need to know as a researcher. So you need to have a good list of methodologies, feel comfortable using them, but then also how do you interpret and empathize with your customer? I think that's something that even no matter what degree I have, it's something that I will always continue to learn. You're never finished learning how to completely empathize and put yourself in the shoes of your customer. So at least for my role, I would say you don't need to take like the path that I took, which is cognitive science, human-centered design and engineering. But if you can familiarize yourself with our research methodologies and then also start developing skills for empathizing, interpreting data, building rapport with your customers, those are just a valuable skill set to have to become a researcher one day.
So I majored in like human factors engineering, like also part of the industry engineering. So all the things that we learned back in school was how do you optimize the system and how do you design like a good like system that allows the people or the human in it to perform the best. And so that was very much relevant to what I do today. And I already established my interest back in the time. And I continue my master degree or my continue my educations in human computer interaction. That's even more focused on just understanding like the interactions between human and the computer or between like software or tech. And those really laying out the foundations and the knowledge of my skill set for UX research.
Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for part 2, where we talk about how to land a job at Microsoft.